Money sent home by overseas Filipinos posted positive growth in the first quarter, or make that first month of the year. Data from the Philippine Central Bank showed personal remittances rose by 3.5% to $3 billion. Of that cash remittances coursed through banks increased by 3.5% as well. The U.S. is the source, make that the top source of overall remittances, followed by Singapore, Japan, and Saudi Arabia. Inflation in Argentina comes in at a whopping 102.5% in February. That's the highest since 1991, when the inflation print exceeded 171%. Argentina has one of the highest inflation rates in the world in 2022. It reached 94.8%. For this year, the government has set a target of 60%. Argentina has been grappling with an economic crisis, registering double-digit inflation numbers in the last 12 years. Well, back here at home, members of the Dominguez carnapping group have been sentenced to life imprisonment over a 12-year-old carnapping homicide case. Our very own Zian Ambrosio now joins us with that story. Zian, over to you.
Carmina, the QCRPC Judge Rafael Hipolito found accused members of the Dominguez carnapping group guilty beyond reasonable doubt for the case of carnapping with homicide for the death of Benson Evangelista in the year 2011. Originally, the said case was filed versus five people, namely Roger Dominguez, Raymond Dominguez, Joel Jacinto, Jason Miranda, and Ronaldo Talban. But Raymond Dominguez died of COVID inside the Bilibid prison, while Jacinto died of heart attack. DACC President Boy Evangelista expressed deep gratitude and became emotional as he was giving his message to the VACC members and to his son, who died 11 years ago. Evangelista says that he promised his son that he will fight till the end, even if it would risk his life. Members of VACC were all happy that they were able to get justice in this case. But for attorney Oscar Caraan, one of the lawyers of the Dominguez carnapping group, they plan to file a motion for reconsideration regarding the said case, as they feel that there was a trial by publicity. The legal team of Evangelista reiterated that with the 12 years, enough evidence and the truth came out through the testimonies of the witnesses. And that's the latest here in Quezon City. Zian Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosio. And that'll do it for today. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency takes back its claim there's a prevailing practice of rewarding informants with confiscated drugs in successful operations. See, it was PDEA Director General Moro Virgilio Lasso who made that claim, but in a Senate hearing, he clarified it's not being observed in the PDEA reward system.
I acted in good faith when I brought to light the reprehensible act of tipsters seeking confiscated drugs as a reward. But I have never imagined that my sincere intention will be misunderstood. I was only relaying my personal experience about my encounter with some of the informants. I want to make it clear that their proposals were rejected outright. The Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency wants to correct the erroneous impression that there is a PDEA policy involving the handing out of non-monetary incentives like recycled illicit drugs. To the best of my knowledge, it has never been a prevailing practice in the PDEA reward system.
Senators, meanwhile, say the PDEA chief could have done more to ensure there's no such practice.
It's possible na yung sinasabi ng asset kay DG Lasso may katotohanan. We have to accept our fault, our weaknesses. Nang sa gayon, doon naman natin masosolve ang isang problema. Maaring may katotohanan, imbis na babanggain nyo, we have to investigate.
This committee is not trying to shoot the messenger. In this case, you are the messenger. We are not trying to shoot you down. We are very thankful of your information. It opened up a can of worms. Now, if the can being opened ay walang laman na worm, okay lang rin. Basta walang katotohanan ang lalabas dito. Yun lang ating gusto talaga. But remember, being the messenger, you still have moral obligation na maparating yung message clearly doon sa intended recipient. Diba? So, with that, again, all day ko, sir, please, due diligence on your part to follow up that informant.